Alexander, how are you?
I'm doing okay. How about you?
I'm great. It's in the morning right now for me. What is it for you?
It is 7:30 p.m.
Ooh, okay. Had your dinner?
What? Not yet. But I eat late. I'm up late, so my whole day is shifted. This is like middle of the day for me.
Okay, all right. So, well, we'll just get right into it, okay? First of all, hello. Your music has been going around. Here in Malaysia, we're getting to know you, getting to know your music. Mainly passed through word of mouth, and we're loving what we hear so far. It's very honest, it's very genuine. Well, that's the feeling that we get, especially. But if you were to meet with your fans here in Malaysia for the first time, how would you introduce yourself to a would-be fan? Would it be like a first-time date?
My favorite way to meet new people and fans is to play for them. So I think in an ideal world, it would just be doing, you know, a show, and getting to meet everyone after the show would be the best way for me to do it.
Okay, what if it was a date? Would you still play for them? Yeah.
Sure, let's go. Yeah, I'll still play. As long as there's someone to play, I'll play it. Simple as that.
That's good. Well, your music does sound great, so that is a wonderful way to approach it. Speaking of a way to get to know each other, how would you describe your music?
Emotional, I think, would be the first word that comes to mind.
How do you go about actually writing your music? Does it come from the heart? Is it like a topic that you want to fight for? Like, what comes first, the idea or the music, the sounds that you make through your instruments?
Yeah, so for me, usually, I mean, it's definitely a little bit different every time, but I think I write about personal experiences pretty much exclusively. So I usually start with the lyrics and just make sure that I'm writing about something that I really, really feel and that I really experienced and that I really want to talk about.
How can you miss someone you've never met? 'Cause I need you now, but I don't know you yet.
Now, when it comes to your latest song, I Don't Know You Yet, I get the feeling of like a sense of longing, missing someone we don't know, hoping to fill a hole in the heart that just seems impossible to fill, and you can't seem to find a person to do just that. How do you cope with feeling that way?
I write songs about it, but okay. Yeah, for me, whenever, you know, something, it, not even just romantically, but whenever there's something out of my control that is bothering me, I try my best to focus back on the things that I can control. So if something out of my control is really bothering me, then I'm just trying to get back to the basics. I'm trying to, you know, make sure I'm getting exercise and eating healthy food and, you know, calling my family and just focusing on things that I, you know, have autonomy over.
Okay, so I like the part where you said, not even just romantically, because this is what I want to talk about as well. It's great. Your songs describe a situation where you're looking for a significant other, and it's perfect for that situation. You feel like it fits, you know. You want that special other, but at the same time, you could also be longing for like friends, just someone to spend your time with.
Oh, certainly. I mean, that's been probably the coolest part of putting this song out, has been other people telling me what it means to them, you know. And it's been everything from, you know, I'm looking for a friend, or I never got a chance to meet my grandfather, or, you know, someone passed away when I was younger and I never got a chance to know them. So, yeah, it's been beautiful to me to see how it resonates with, you know, different people in different ways.
I've been trying to think, like, what's giving us this feeling of longing and this feeling of incompleteness, if that is even a word. Do you feel like in a modern world, we are very connected, but at the same time, emotionally, we're quite disconnected? Do you agree? If not, what are your reasons?
Yeah, no, I do agree. I think that the easier it gets to talk to people, the harder it gets to form, you know, deeper relationships with people, almost definitionally. So, and I think this song definitely addresses, you know, that as well, and in kind of like a subconscious way.
When it comes to communicating with people, do you prefer the more traditional method? I saw in your video where you're tossing roses to people. Well, you're riding a bike, you're tossing roses, and it's a bit more genuine in a way. If you had given the choice, is your preferred form of communication maybe by mail, or is it by typing or texting?
It's definitely not texting. I'm very, very not good at that. For me, I mean, like, I almost exclusively FaceTime people as far as like a mode of conversation. I love just like, you know, if I can't go see you face to face, which now it's obviously harder than ever to do that, I want to at least have, you know, something like this where you can read each other's facial expressions and really get to know someone a little bit better than just texting or even calling. Just there's something about seeing someone visually that you really just can't replace with any form of communication.
yeah, speaking of speaking face to face and not being able to do that, what has your lockdown has been like? What have you been doing to fill your time? Are you coping with it okay? Are you okay?
I mean, it's been hard for me in a lot of ways, and I think I have it better than, you know, 99.99999% of people in the world. I live in a house with friends, and I work from home. I have a studio in my house. So, you know, as far as just like daily routine, it doesn't change my, you know, home life that much, but just, you know, like I used to get to stay home and make music by myself by choice. Now it's not my choice anymore. So it's just like that part's been difficult to reckon with, but you know, it's definitely ups and downs.
So it's more like, oh, I guess I'm stuck at home now.
I'm doing what I would normally do, but it just feels different.
You run away by when things get bad. I pretend nothing can make me sad. And I don't know what is worse. Is it running or pretending that there's nothing to run?
On the opposite spectrum of staying inside, you've had experience playing for a big crowd before. I know you've gone around playing music with, you opened for Alec Benjamin, if I'm not mistaken. You followed him around on tour. What is it like playing your music, which I feel to be very intimate and it's really suitable and really lovely to hear in a small room with a group of friends? What is it like for you to play that with a bigger crowd?
I think it's equally beautiful, just kind of in different ways, but I mean, I feel like there's a number of people where, you know, there's an inflection point where it goes from like seeing individual people's faces to it's almost like performing for one person. You can't pick people out. It's like almost like you're performing for one person. But I love both just the same, the intimate stuff. And obviously as it gets bigger, just like, I mean, it's what makes concerts so special to me is like, it's not often that you have so many people all in one place listening to like one song, feeling the same, you know, things. So you know, the more the merrier, honestly. It just makes it a cooler collective experience.
I know some artists, they go about changing their music a bit, especially on the slower songs. They try to make it a little bit more upbeat. Do you go that route, or do you go like, is this a bigger crowd but it still has the same intimacy? Which way do you go?
Definitely. Well, I think it kind of depends on the exact, you know, if it's my show, then I'll probably play the song, you know, slow and intimately. But you know, if maybe someone hasn't heard my music before and I'll be fighting, you know, I'm the opener, like, it kind of just depends on the opportunity, but usually I try and stay like pretty true to the song.
Another song that I like from you is one that I feel confuses me. Don't take it the wrong way. It's cool. It's called See You Later. And the reason why it confuses me, because it plays with my emotions. At the same time, the lyrics is like a bit down. The mood, you have, even the music, you feel as though it's a bit of a somber tone, but at the same time, it's a little upbeat as well. It has like a melancholic undertone, but a cheery beat. If you can get what I'm trying to say here, sorry. So, What was it like? Does it play into the lyrics where you're confused about staying, but at the same time you have to leave? A bit more on that song.
Yeah, so I think, I mean, one of my favorite tools as a songwriter and producer is contrast. And I think sometimes my favorite songs, you know, will be about something super sad and heartfelt and, you know, tragic in some ways. And then you kind of put a fun beat over it, and it's like that, you know, confusion is definitely intentional. So you're not crazy for feeling like that, you know, like, I think it gives people a chance to listen to it in kind of two ways. You know, you can put it on at a party and it, you know, goes fine and blends in, but you can also put it on, you know, by yourself in headphones at night and kind of really dig deep into the lyrics and get more sentimental with it.
As we dig into the lyrics, I feel like we get to know you more, and I feel like you're a genuine person. What is it like getting ready for a show? When you want to perform, how do you set up yourself? Do you think a lot about how you look? Do you think about how you're going to perform? Are you going to present yourself on stage? What is that like?
Definitely. I mean, I take performing super seriously. You know, it's my job, and people are there and they're paying there, you know, paying to see me and to hear my music. So I want to do whatever I can to give people, you know, the best show that I possibly can. But at the same time, I think for me, performing is like, that's like kind of the that's the present. That's the cherry on top of it all. You know, I put in all the hard work. I practice a lot. I warm up. But when I'm out there, I'm just having fun, you know, and trying to like be in the moment and connect with people in real time.
Yeah, having fun and connecting with people, that is really important. A hot take. People, musicians, they're lovely. They have genuine ideas. They're lovely to listen to. They start out that way. But then as they start to grow bigger, there's a chance. Not all artists definitely get this, but there's a chance that maybe they get a bit more scheduled. There's like, okay, I want to come out a song in 3 months. Not because I have a song to come out that I really want to share, but because I have to in 3 months. I got to get a song out. And so they put out a song that they think could be right, but it's not really from the heart. Do you feel like that is something that might affect you in the future? Are you afraid of it? Do you think you ever end up that way?
I mean, I think that's, first of all, it's very perceptive, and I agree with you, definitely. I think you kind of get trapped into this, you know, the competition aspect of music, and you lose kind of a bit why you started doing it in the first place. But I'm super conscious of that, and I'm thinking about that every step of the way, like, is this the right song for right now? So, you know, hopefully I'm going to do my best not to kind of fall into that rat race of sorts.
Okay, speaking of your music, what are your motivations? What drives you to make your music? Other than just being able to express yourself, is there a person in your life that really motivates you to do music?
My parents were always super supportive my entire life of my music and my songwriting and my music career and stuff. So they've definitely, you know, inspired me in their own ways to do this. But I think bigger than anything is like, I'm just a regular guy with regular feelings, but I just happen to have, you know, my job and my talent is putting these kind of intangible feelings into tangible songs. And so I almost feel a responsibility as a person with emotions to kind of put this music out, and because what I'm feeling isn't unique, you know, people around the world are clearly feeling the same way. So it's like, if I can, you know, just put it into writing with a melody and a beat, then, you know, that's what I want to do.
Yeah, we feel the same things. We are all human after all. Speaking of being human, it's not every day you see a person, like maybe 1 out of 10, maybe out of 1 out of 30, you say, yeah, my career path is being a musician. Do you ever doubt yourself about doing music?
I mean, every day, I think you'd be lying if you said no. I mean, I don't doubt necessarily that I am, you know, doing the wrong career path, or that, you know, my whole life is out of whack. Like, it's more just like, you know, as a, you know, songwriter, you can't write the best song of your life every day. It's just not how it works. But at the same time, as a person, as an emotional person, you know, it's very easy, obviously, to get frustrated when, you know, you're having a bad day and you're like, you know, did I lose it? Am I not good anymore? You know, am I ever going to write another song that I love again? And that stuff happens too. And it's almost like you just, you know, have memory loss every time you write a good song, you know, but yeah, I mean, I feel that every day in different ways.
Your friends around you, how do they play into your songs, the people you meet? I of course, they inspire you, but in what way?
I'm so inspired by my friends that are kind of like on the same come up as me, I think more than anyone. And just like watching them do their thing propels me, you know, forward to kind of try and be the best version of myself as well. You know, when I see a friend of mine that puts out a video to a song that I love, that's just beautiful, it's the perfect pair, you know, it inspires me to be like, you know what, I need to really step on my game and work harder on the video aspect of, you know, my music. And, so yeah, I think it's a healthy relationship though that I have with my friends, where I'm simultaneously so happy for their success, and also it motivates me to you know, work harder and be better.
I used to like to go out before I met you. Now I just go out to forget you. Put my nice shoes on so strangers can't tell that I miss your dirty Air Force Ones.